teams for this match, send hashtag GVWin or hashtag CLGWin to at Aloe Esports. We'll be checking in shortly on the...
...up the dragon, and they've actually had him switch objectives top lane and start shoving it heavily instead of trying to freeze it.
Should be able to get some good damage on it. If not, just take the turn.
Yeah. No Lulu ultimate, no Hecarim ultimate, no Homeguard boost for Hecarim. And Gravity are happy to take some damage. Looks like they're going to go 50-50 on this dragon.
Oh, it's ambitious! By Smithy versus the double AP, and Gravity looks to make a move.
Here's one of those hooks!
Xsmithy flashes up, the rocket comes out, the last bite's going over to Xsmithy on Rek'Sai first. Cool. There's
another hook.
CLG. Looking to get more. That's the ultimate we're talking about. Xsmithy's on the front line. Aphromoo gets double lift out with the wild growth on. Here comes Haunter. Xsmithy now is going to go down. Did Aphromoo want the pull? Gravity actually can't
Hecarim,
follow
though.
Up. Backside. Hecarim comes in. Zion Spartan can't really get the hit on. He gets focused with quite a bit of damage. They do take down St. Vicious. Aiken for some bacon. CLG pick up one more. And it
and lasers to try and even take him out. And they almost got him out. But CLG pick up the extra. They can go 1-3-1 split push really easily.
Oh,
yeah, he's a bit ahead
word.
Of Monster. Three levels and a lot. Yep, he's dosed.
Aphromoo gets the assist. What a nice guy.
See, they wait multiple people to teleport down to the bottom lane that can turn fights. But they're just going to get the inhibitor all by themselves.
Just brute forcing it. There's not much that Gravity can do. They're going to try to refight this. Keen fires out the laser.
Remand for himself.
Oh, Smithy. I think he's going to get himself caught. Zion Spartan needs to run the other way. It takes so long just to take Xsmithy.
Air them off. Zion just beating his chest, yelling at them. Buys time for the rest of the team to finish Baron, and now he goes in.
He gets to the back line. I don't think Gravity's going to have much to be able to say about this one. The
There's
Victor
the
lockdown is actually on the other side. Does get Aphromoo down 1-for-1 so far, but it does not look like Gravity is long for this world. And they will for purchases, and they are right back in the face of Gravity. If we look on the map right now, I think there's one ward for Gravity. They have not had much chance to get those wards out, and if they do, they're being choked out by Counter Logic Game.
Hyper carries in the game.
It's crazy. The shield's on. That's 5 seconds of Whimsy if he wants the speed up. And it is a completely safe double lift. That's also going to be a get excited. And a little crowded in the base, Kobe. Every witch lane comes crashing in now. St. Vicious going for broke, goes for Link, and he gets swiped right off the boar. They're going to try as much as they can. Haunter goes in with the Zanyas.
Oh, double goes down.
The Tome. And that may be the DPS they needed to actually finish the fight. You look around, and Zion Spartan's really the one to offer.
And over with the Trinity empowered attacks.
Oh, crushing that down. Just a few more hits. And they do respect Keen's laser.
This is a good exercise in poking and prodding for CLG with that.
Cop, he's getting hit up by Zion Spartan. Zion's forced to turn. Saint's still pretty tanky, and they are trading damage back well as Haunter was the first focus. But you forgot about double lift on the back line. A double kill. There could be a triple and a quadra, but it doesn't pop hard enough. And it is going to be Link taken down number 3. CLG's going to have the base.
Yeah, congratulations to CLG. Taking it over Gravity. Second time, I believe.
Yep. CLG taking this game back in week 3, now to week 7. Just 4 later, they did their homework, figured out what composition needed to be played. They came out with a Hecarim and the Lulu this time in the top in the mid lane. And it's Counter Logic Gaming will take down Gravity.
Yeah, Link showing that he plays mid lane, AD carry, and support.
And support
from the mid lane.
That's right.
So versatility still definitely intact for CLG.
A different look in Lulu than we see there towards the early game with a bit more cool down, the lucidity, the control. He's still built in that power of the Zanyas, the Rabadons, but everything was focused on to double lift, back to the protect double lift and let him carry like a boss with Zion Spartan also being gigantic in the top lane just because that's Zion Spartan this season.
Yeah, once again, early stages played out really well from CLG. The lane swaps.
Yep. Wow. A lot approaching. And giving high fives to the crowd. There's that bottom lane rush hour. Ooh, wins right there. Props to that guy. St. Vicious with good plays in the early game, getting himself those smites in, controlling objectives for the team. but it just seemed like the warding CLG was able to do left Saint nowhere to go that he wasn't seen. They knew everything that he was doing, and it's hard to counter or even create your own ganks when you're always in the eyes of the enemy.
Yeah, extra mobility from CLG, constantly pressuring the map. Calm and controlled.
Calm and controled, indeed. Methodical as well, 11-4. Like we said, once they were inside that base, they were still textbook split pushing. They could have gone straight for the turrets, but they didn't want to lose too many deaths. Obviously get a few more fantasy points for themselves. It's always nice to tack on. But we do see a little bit more versatility here from Counter Logic Gaming as they bring out, as we said, the Hecarim and the Lulu. So what do you do next? How do you ban against this team? Something for other teams to think about. Towards the top of the list, Counter Logic Gaming looks to face Team Solo Mid in Week 8, Team Impulse in Week 9 as well. Games for them to definitely look at along the road for them. Gravity also has Team Solo Mid and Cloud9 coming up in